Working at this restaurant up in my hometown, and I've been working here for about 2 years. I was a busboy and then a dishwasher, and then I was a cook, and I just, you know,
oh, really?
I was graduating high school. It was my senior year of high school, and I couldn't hack staying around the town, and even working in this restaurant, I'd be living at home, so I, you know, it was time for a change. And some kid that I worked with came down here and he told me about, you know, how much money you could make. So I decided, you know,
yeah,
the hell with it. Like, I didn't even go to graduation. I came down here and I started working.
How many other clam openers are there out here?
In this town?
Just on the seaside, the boardwalk and stuff.
So, 1, 2, 3, 4, about 5 clam bars.
Do you know them all? I mean, do you know all the guys who open them?
Most of them are kids who haven't really been doing it. I used to get challenged. One night. Somebody from the end, you know, because came down. Like, I'm sure he hears that kid at Junior's, man, that kid is the fastest kid I've seen alive. And like, if you're over there busting your hump, you know, you're opening clams, you don't want to hear that this kid's fast. So one night, he and his friend, one kid came down and he said, "I hear you're fast, why don't you open a clam for me?" Like, I had no business, no customers at all. And he said, "I'm not going to open a clam for you." And he said, the kid started talking. I opened clams at, you know, at Bob's Ranch House, real bullshit operation. And I said, "So how long have you been opening clams?" He said, "4 months." I said, "Get out of here. Get the hell out of here." And like 2 nights later, he brought his friend down. His friend came down and he ordered, he said, "Let me have 6 clams." And he said, and when I got to the 5th clam, he said, "Let me open it myself." You know, so he said, "Well, you know, I'm not really allowed to let you do this. You might hurt yourself and I'm responsible." And so the kid grabbed it and he went, "Shh," and he got it open. A lot of motion, but he got it open. And I got into a rap with him. It almost turned into a thing where, you know, it's like Wild Wild West, where I was going to get a holster for a clam knife, put 6 clams on a plate.
Watch the hour now, Hawaii on Meatball.
Well, where'd you get the name?
The name of the place is Meatball City. Well, it started out as Seafood City and didn't do very good. So the following year, we changed it to Meatball City. And
everybody else walks in now, front side is that time, all over. Try to order every game, anybody else ready to race? Anybody else do not wear a clean before? Anybody else? Let me back it up for you, make it before. Anybody else ready in the game? The more the bigger the prize is order to every time.
It's fun, that's all?
It's fun.
What kind of fun? What do you do? Well, tell me some of the secrets of what you do to have fun.
I play the stands.
You play the stands? You ever win?
Yeah, all the time.
How do you win?
Well, when the thing goes round to the number that you want, you press the button and it comes up.
You got a system.
Yeah.
Does it work all the time?
Yeah.
Beautiful. What's your name?
Billy Volker.
What do you come down here for? You live around here?
Nah, I live in Elizabeth. I'm down with my sister.
You come down here a lot?
Yeah.
This advantage. Let's come on over and take advantage of this game. Right there, there goes another coin. Come on over and take advantage of this game.
How's that ice cream cone?
Oh, it's going to heck out of here.
It looks like it's going all over the place.
My poor daughter's home with the cold. She's waiting for a contact. So,
you come down here often?
Oh, yeah. Every year.
I
love it down
here.
Can't beat it.
Really?
It's out as well.
Where?
People are more friendlier than before. You know, everybody, you know, hello, a smile. Before, people used to just walk by.
Really?
Yeah. I think it's a lot more friendly.
Well, this dough here is, like, too soft to do it. It's been sitting out too long.
Oh, yeah?
And when it gets too soft, you can't look good flipping it.
Yeah.
Who kind of cigarettes over here? Tobacco! We even have five varieties over here. Tobacco, 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 five varieties of tobacco. Right over here, we got cigars and cigarettes, a full cart, setbacks. Yeah, full cart, setbacks right over here. We give you a full cart, setbacks every time.
Hey, I'll go for one.
I believe Seaside is a little different than the average resort in that it's not as large as most.
Yeah, not like Atlantic
City. It's concentrated. If you walk the boardwalk, it'll take you 15 minutes from one end to the other. That way you can walk back and forth and see everything there is to see.
$50 short. I was ringing up the taxes, not ringing up the taxes. I made up my own system, you know?
Kept you.
Yeah, it kept me.
How'd you get into clams? How'd you start this?
He asked the old man to say I was a biology major. I asked him for the job.
Yeah?
Yeah, he was sitting on a bench, and I opened up. He said, let me see you open a clam. The old man's a real gentleman when he opens a clam. He gave me the clam, here, and I started opening right over here. I started opening it right there, like that. I'll take it out. I started opening it like this. Forget it. So I started selling corn. After that, I worked in the cellar. I did everything, made steaks. Then I finally got here. I think somebody died. They put me back here, and they taught me how to do this. The life story. Oh, I think so. Like, we've had plenty of parties, man. Like, 4 o'clock to 7 o'clock in the morning. We've got nothing else to do except get drunk and hang out together. You know, after seeing each other on the stand, you think they'd all go in different directions. But people really like each other.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.